gym floor used to have a few soft spots on it, so if you're dribbling along and you hit a soft spot, the ball wouldn't come back up the way you thought it might.
Home court advantage has not changed a bit over the decades. And the current UBC Thunderbirds are fully aware the last time the national championship was held on this floor, UBC won the title.
We only had to win two games at the national. There was just a semifinal and a final, four teams only.
It happened in 1972. The year MASH made his television debut, and the Godfather hit the big screen.
And I refused to be a fool.
44 years later...
I want to tell a little story here.
Members of that 72 championship team cannot help but reminisce of those glory days.
Rod was the Swiss Army knife of our team. He played wherever he was needed. We were probably one of the smallest teams to ever play for the Thunderbirds.
Rod Matheson, John Mills, and the rest of the T-Birds had an up-and-down season that year, but peaked just at the right time. They were led by a superstar guard, the late Ron Thorson, the only UBC player to have ever been drafted by the NBA.
It was a really treat for us to play with him for 3 years.
To be able to watch him perform was really something.
And then there's their Australian-born head coach, Peter Mullins, who died 4 years ago. Mullins was an acquired taste.
He would explode.
Known for his colorful language.
He had the 2-foot stomp, which began with raising his elbows and then stamping down on the floor.
In the national final, down in the first half, the T-Birds came back for a lopsided win over Windsor.
We did have a sense of confidence. We understood what each other was supposed to be doing, what our roles were.
But we were really a team that was greater than the sum of the parts. Keep your poise and stay under control on the floor. That was the mantra.
Sage advice for the 2016 team from the gentlemen who were the last to raise a national basketball banner on campus.
Well, it's sort of always a dream to come out to UBC and maybe play ball for UBC.
Hi, I'm Jack Hoy, a proud member of the 1972 National Champion Thunderbird basketball team. I played my high school basketball in North Vancouver at a school called Delbrook, which burned down in 1977 and was never rebuilt. We were fortunate to play with Canada's best player of the era, Ron Thorson. Ron was a pit of the Pistol Pete Maravich ilk and had creative ways to get the ball to his open teammates. You had to be ready. We were coached by the talented and legendary Peter Mullins, who had a demonstrative manner on the bench, sometimes using colorful language. We were a great fast-breaking team, with Ron usually leading the charge. One memory that sticks out in my mind was when Ron took the ball to the hoop on a break and the shot was taken away, so he passed the ball behind his back to a wide open Daryl Jurnas for a layup. Unfortunately, the ball hit Daryl in the face and went out of bounds. Peter rose to his feet with this classic double stomp, yelling, "Daryl, were you ready for that pass?" Daryl shrugged and Mullins replied, "For God's sakes, you know he throws the ball out of his..." Well, I'll let you use your imagination to finish Peter's oration. The best memory of all? We were national champs.
This is a team jacket from 1967. It gives me an opportunity to segue into a little story about Memorial Gym. Back in those days, Memorial Gym was a very busy place. Phys ed classes, as well as varsity practices and intramurals. For basketball, we had three teams practicing at the same time. The women's team, the JV team, and the Thunderbirds playing cross-court. And also, for guys that are on the current team, if you think that, that the team room is crowded, back then, you'd be sharing it with the JVs as well.
Thank you. we don't get pool again. A change, it had to come. We knew it all along. We were liberated from the bullet song. And the world looks just the same if history ain't changed. Cause the banners, they all flown in the last war. I'll tip my hat to the new Constitution.
Hi. I'm Peter Hurd, and here's my version of the 1972 season. On paper, the 72 team wasn't as good as the 71 team that got beaten by Manitoba in the Western Final. Our two national team forwards had graduated, and we were left with a bunch of no-names, plus Ron Thorson, the best player in the country at the point. We were probably the quickest team in the country, but we might also have been the shortest, and we struggled through the season. We were 13-3 in the Pacific Division, 21-10 overall. As the playoffs approached, John Mills was becoming a presence in the paint, often against centers who were 4 or 5 inches taller, and Stan Caligari was becoming deadly from outside. The rest of us were getting better too, and the team was playing well, so cause for optimism. We absolutely destroyed Alberta in the Pacific Final. Although we lost Game 1 of the Western Final by 3 points to Saskatchewan, we didn't panic and we came back and beat them by 17-22. Good thing it was best 2 out of 3, because only the conference champs made it to the Nationals. In the National Semifinal, we beat Windsor 117-84, with Thorson scoring 40-something. But then the strangest thing happened. In the final, Ron couldn't put the ball in the basket. Fortunately, Stan stepped up with 22 all-in long-range bombs, and John Mills, in one of the greatest performances in CIS history, came up with 27 points and 18 rebounds as we beat Acadia 87-80. CBC Television insisted that the game be played at 10 o'clock in the morning, so we were partying by early afternoon, but that's another story.
Hi, my name is Daryl Jernis, a proud member of the 1972 UBC Thunderbirds basketball team. In 1972, miniskirts and bell-bottoms were hot. The Godfather and Deliverance were hits at the box office, and MASH had made its television debut. American Pie and Horse with No Name topped the music charts. Prime Minister Pierre Trudeau was our Prime Minister, while U.S. President Richard Nixon made an unprecedented visit to China during the Vietnamese War. The technological revolution had begun with the sale of a handheld calculator. It sold for around $400. My $2 bill could buy a 4 gallons of gas, and the average Vancouver house price was $32,000. A glass of beer cost me 20 cents. The year was 1972. This was the last time a UBC men's basketball team won the Canadian Championship. Winning the national title was truly a highlight of my life. After moving here to Vancouver from Regina in grade 11 and then graduating from Sir Winston Churchill, I had the honor of playing for the legendary coach, Dr. Peter Mullins, and the privilege of playing with our captain, the incredible Ron Thorson. I was also lucky enough to experience the inspirational and steadfast leadership of teammate John Mills. My teammates were a group of selfless, wonderful men that to this day I can truly call my friends. Many other long-lasting friendships were also born out of those great years spent on the hardwood floors of War Memorial Gym. Thank you.
You may have heard stories about our coach Peter Mullins. They're all true. Peter set high standards, and he expected his players to meet them. One of his pet peeves was the chest pass, for the obvious reason that it was easy to intercept. During a practice one day, some poor sod delivered a chest pass, which, surprise, got picked off. We all stopped dead in our tracks. As Peter turned red, steam started coming out of his ears, and he was about to explode when Millsy blurted out, "Peter! Forgive us our chest passes, as we forgive those who trespass against us." Peter stood there with his mouth hanging open. There were a few chuckles, and we returned to practice. That was the only time I ever saw Peter Mullins at a loss for words.
Back in our day, we were very fortunate to have strong support from our fans. In fact, very frequently, there would be a number of them who would show up to watch our Thursday noon hour practices. One particular game was memorable. This was the first game of the Canada West final against Saskatchewan, who surprised us. We were down 21 at the half, but came back to a standing ovation. We weren't able to win that game, but certainly the team's resilience, buoyed by the fans, meant that we won the next two games very handily.
UBC Sports Hall of Fame inductee in the team category. 1971-72 men's basketball. The last UBC team to have won the CIS Men's Basketball Championship was coached by Peter Mullins and led by future national team players Ron Thorson and John Mills. After finishing first in the West Division of the Western Canadian Conference with a 13-3 record, the Thunderbirds then defeated second-place Alberta Golden Bears in two games of a best-of-three conference championship. They then met the Great Plains Division champion, Saskatchewan Huskies, for the league championship, prevailing 2-1. With just a 10-man roster, UBC then played host to the National Championship Tournament at War Memorial Gym. Led by league scoring leader Ron Thorson's 43-point performance, the Thunderbirds defeated Ontario champion Windsor Lancers by a convincing margin of 117-84 in a sudden-death semifinal. And as a capacity hometown crowd looked on, Mullins and his charges then won the national title. Congratulations to 2016 inductee in the team category, 1971-72 UBC Thunderbird men's basketball team.
Hi, I'm John Mills, You might remember me from the 1970 and 1972 UBC Thunderbird National Basketball Championship teams. I'm here today to bring greetings to one of the great sporting institutions of the province of Manitoba. They won multiple national basketball championships in the 90s and the early part of this century. Brandon Bobcats set a high standard for basketball. I'm proud to bring greetings to the University of Manitoba, who during the 70s, 80s, and 90s dominated university volleyball in Canada. On behalf of the UBC Thunderbirds, I'm proud to bring greetings to the University of Manitoba single national championship team of 1975. We were expecting to see them in 1972 at the Western Final, but some guys in green showed up and we sent them home and went on to win our second national championship. But, you know, all of that is in the past, and what's really important is that university sport was a great developing ground for all of us, and it was a wonderful opportunity with terrific opposition, wonderful competition, and we're proud to extend our congratulations to the University of Manitoba for a couple of years of excellence and decades of adequacy and a century of excitement to the University of Winnipeg.